Ladies and gentlemen, the following six-man tag team contest, our feature confrontation, is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Washington, D.C., the Patriot. From Marietta, Georgia, Marcus Alexander Bagwell. They are the team of Stars and Stripes. And their tag team partner is from Glens Falls, New York, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
All we need is Bill Clinton and we'll be all set to go.
Well, he's got enough problems. All right, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, Stars and Stripes, facing the combination of the World Tag Team Champions, Pretty Wonderful, and the World Television Champion. And I know that sticks in your craw, Larry.
Don't get me started.
Lord Steven Regal. You can hear the crowd picking up the chant now, USA, USA. A fantastic crowd on hand, a turnaway of about 1,000 people. And they are seeing some great action. Let's go back to our ring announcer.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, first, from the Tower of Blackpool, he weighs 18 stones, 2 pounds, he is the World Tag Team Champion, Lord Steven Regal. His tag team partners from Tampa, Florida, 250 pounds, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Wonder. His tag team partner from New York City, 242 pounds,
there you see him, Paul Roma, Lord Steven Regal, and Paul Orndorff. We just talked to Roma and Orndorff a few moments ago. They're very confident about this coming Wednesday night. Lord Regal, of course, facing tremendous international competition on the Clash of Champions, taking on Antonio Inoki.
Yeah, Inoki again, another tremendous mat wrestler. I mean, years of experience and wisdom. It's going to be a great clash, Gordon. I hope Lord Regal gets creamed.
Well, we're sure going to find out. And the crowd into a fever pitch now.
What?
As we're getting set to watch this match.
I can't hear anything in here.
They are really excited about it. Hacksaw Jim Duggan along with the Patriot Marcus Alexander Bagwell. The Stars and Stripes. And, you know, it's interesting, though, to watch Roma's face. He very rarely changes expression. It's hard to read this man.
Well, he's got a face of stone, no question about that. But very intense individual is what I read out of him. Roma, I think, is just beaming with confidence. I think under the influence and tutoring of Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. I mean, you've got to learn. This man's just been around. He's great. And, boy, I don't like Lord Regal, but again, a great mat wrestler. It's going to be an interesting matchup here.
It is indeed. I'm going to have some comments this coming Friday night on the 900 line, the wrestling hotline. I think the folks will find interesting.
Well, look on the other side of the coin here. We got the Patriot, big mysterious guy, Marcus Bagwell, coming along, but young, and Hacksaw Duggan. Now, does this guy have a full deck?
Well, some people have said that his elevator doesn't stop at every floor. I think it does. But he knows how to psych his people out.
Well, I tell you, he's got a good psychological ploy going here against Lord Regal. Nothing irritates the Lord more than this. Feel like chanting it myself.
And it does have Regal upset, and Duggan still moving around the ring. Regal at 254 pounds, 18 stone and 2, that's 252 plus 2, so that's 254 pounds for Regal.
You know, interesting thing to note here, Lord Regal this Wednesday against Inoki, Pretty Wonderful, tag team championships of the world. You know, can these guys afford to get hurt here, get injured here at the hands of Stars and Stripes and Hacksaw?
Well, it could very easily happen because Hacksaw always carries that 2x4 with him.
That helps.
Yeah, it'll get your attention in a hurry. Ah, Roma. elbow to the midsection, slashing left hand, and Duggan fires back. A series of hard right hands to the side of the jaw of Roma puts him down to the canvas.
Well, we'll see if his face has any expression on it now.
You can hear Duggan chanting USA in the crowd. I mean, there's a little doll picking up the comments and the phrases of USA. Well, judging from the comments from Hulk Hogan earlier, boy, it all goes on the line Wednesday night. For a complete update of everything that's going to take place on Wednesday, too, we invite you to be sure and check out WCW Saturday Night, tonight, 6:05. And, of course, on Sunday night, on the main event. Arndorf squares up against Marcus Alexander Bagwell. Bagwell gets the side headlock.
You know, looking at this situation now, I think Bagwell's the man that Pretty Wonderful and Lord Regal are going to try to slow down. He'd be the one that they'd like to try to get to.
No. Well, so far they're having a hard time doing a full body slam by Bagwell. The Patriot catches Orndorff, then Duggan catches him, then Bagwell catches him. Orndorff must feel like a punching bag right now.
Time to regroup.
Yeah, it's time to get back in the corner and talk this one over.
Again, with the egos of Lord Regal and Orndorff and Roma, how are they going to communicate in a, you know, six-man tag team situation? It's going to be interesting here.
Takedown by Regal, but he got a little extra leverage that time, and referee Nick Patrick very alertly caught it, calling for the break on this. Bagwell slipped away from it before the break. Arm drag and twist, and now it's Regal utilizing those ring ropes as a tag team partner and forces the break.
Yeah, well, the ring is an effective weapon if you know how to use it right, know how to use the corners, know how to use the ropes for both punishing an opponent and escape. Why waste the energy when you can merely step over a rope?
Excellent point, Larry. And, you know, we haven't talked a whole lot other than on the first match about the fact that our teammate here on the WCW Pro team, Dusty Rhodes, will be in action Wednesday night along with his son, Dustin, taking on Bunkhouse Buck and, of course, Terry Funk.
It's going to be wild.
And to watch out for then will be indeed Arn Anderson and Colonel Parker and, of course, Mink. Orndorff down to the canvas now. Wide stance by the Patriot keeps the arm bar high up on the shoulder of Orndorff.
You know, I didn't think that Pretty Wonderful and Lord Regal would be in this type of a predicament here. These guys, Stars and Stripes, Hacksaw, they're all over these guys. Oh!
Orndorff ran into that one, and brother, those knees have turned to rubber. He turns around and catches one right square on the chops. Orndorff back to his feet now. Full arm drag and twist once again. Tag is made. Marcus Alexander Bagwell moves in. Bagwell putting the pressure on Orndorff now. Tries an Irish whip. Reversed by Orndorff, and Bagwell over that top rope crashes down. He missed the padding and hit the concrete.
Boy, you know, I look outside the ring here. I see Jerkington. I see Jerkington there, Sir William. You know, I got to think, you know, in the midst of Bagwell suffering here. Talk about, you know, Flair and Hogan again. What's Hogan thinking about with Cherry outside the ring? We know how vicious she can be. We know about the surprise Flair's talking about.
Yeah, yeah. It'll be I'll be curious to see what does happen. Wouldn't miss it for the world. Of course, you can't eliminate the Mouth of the South either, Jimmy Hart. Again, the crowd picks up the chant of USA, solidly behind the Stars and Stripes and Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Orndorff having a seizure.
Crashes down on the back of the head of Marcus Bagwell. Makes the tag with the Lord Stephen Regal.
You know, they got to their man, Gordon. I was talking earlier. Bagwell's the one that logically, I think, the three of them would zero in on, being the youngest, the least experienced, the most vulnerable. And look at them. They got their man.
Yep. He would be very wise to get over and tag up now.
That's easier said than done.
That last move by Regal will stretch those hamstring muscles. Beautiful bolo-like forearm. There it is again. Boy, those are effective.
Yeah, those are nasty. They bounce right off the chest, come up and clock you right in the jaw. So to the referee, it looks like a legal type of blow, but it's basically a shot in the mouth.
Yeah, technically it is. But it does glance off the chest, and that's what makes it legal. Oh, Romanov punishing the quadricep femoris muscles.
Oh, and Dugan almost threw the referee out. This guy's not completely there, is he?
Well, he does have recognition problems occasionally.
I think he saw walking tall too many times with that stick.
Bagwell trying to get over and tag up. Stopped, cut off at the pass by Paul Roma. Roma up on the second rope now moves up on that top rope. He's poised on the turnbuckles, flying through space, crashes down across the chest of Marcus Alexander Bagwell. Caught him right at the edge of the rib cage. Patriot broke that one up, and Roma started to charge him. The Patriot squared off, and Roma backed away.
And look at Orndorff. He's right there on the money. That referee turns his back for a couple of seconds. Orndorff's there. There's Regal. Bagwell's the prey, and they've got him, Gordon. I hate to say it, but they got him.
Yeah, if they can get him back into the ring, he's going to be their target, no question about it. Wait a minute. Duggan's got that 2x4.
Looking at himself disqualified.
Bagwell back in the ring. He needs desperately to get over and tag up. Bagwell in a lot of trouble here. They're putting a hurting on him.
Yeah, they got him just where they want him. Look at the ring positioning. He's in their territory. They're tagging in and tagging out. Got him on the outside. Of course, they got Jerkington in there. And here goes Orndorff. No!
Bagwell got him. 1-2. Oh, thought he had him for a pinfall. He hooked him real neatly.
2.5. Almost made the tag, but again, Mr. Wonderful is there. Orndorff, I mean, as time goes on, this guy gets stronger. Low!
Bagwell taking defensive action. And Orndorff charged in. Hacksaw Jim Duggan is tagged up. And brother, he doesn't need a 2x4.
Oh.
Regal hurdles Duggan outside the
They're
ring.
They're all in there.
Duggan caught from behind by Sir William. The referee calls for the bell.
Patrick can't take it anymore. There's Jerkington.
He's got him up in the air, hurdles him down on Lord Stephen Regal. The referee has called for the bell. We've got total bedlam in the ring. And what has Duggan done? Duggan stole Sir William's hat and his parasol. Oh, come on. Ha, ha, ha. Oh, this guy's too much.
It's like Mr. Poppins.
USA! Go!
He said it. USA, USA. Well, Well, you saw the referee. Had all he could stand. Finally called for the bell. We'll be back in just a minute.